A very good afternoon to one and all, respected dignitaries, teachers, and my dear student managers. We welcome you to the induction presentation 2019-21. I'm Aishwarya Shetty, along with my presenter of the day.
I am Prashansa Sinha.
And we are from River Kaveri. So before proceeding ahead with our topic, Prashansa, would you like to share your childhood memory that is related to our topic?
Yeah, sure. I would like to share my memory. But before that, I want to ask my audience, are you all aware of Dadi Nani Ma Ke Nuskhe? Yes, so my story is, my memory is also related to that. In my childhood, I used to fall sick at very random. And my grandmother forcefully used to make me eat DABUR CHYAWAN PRASH daily in the morning. And seriously guys, I hate to have it at that time. But now I realize it is very important for our immunity.
Yeah, that's true. I think we all relate with that. So continuing with our topic of the day, presentation topic is market expansion strategy of DABUR with reference to DABUR CHYAWAN PRASH.
So this will be our agenda for today's topic. Corporate glance. Yes, DABUR is one of the world's largest Ayurveda company. It is having a network over 100 countries across the globe, founded by Dr. S.K. Burman, and the current CEO is Sunil Duggal. Can you guys tell me who is a brand ambassador of DABUR?
No.
Sorry guys, it is Jackie Fernandez.
So as we all know that DABUR has acquired its footprints across various diversified sectors. So for the smooth functioning and proper management, it has been further classified into three categories, and those are healthcare product division, family product division, and Ayurvedic specialties limited. So here are some of the products of DABUR that is being distinguished into different categories.
As Aishwarya has shown you in the previous slide, the distribution of products in different categories. So here is their sales breakdown. And coming to the revenue of DABUR, it is 8,533 crore in financial year 19. And its market capitalization is 67,048 crore in financial year 19. So let's have a look at a video.
लेकिन तभी बारिश आ गई। मम्मी ने कहा था कुछ भी हो, देखना मत। बारिश ने मेरा सॉलिड पोपलो बनाया और बीमार भी मैं।
बारिशों में बच्चों को भीगने से रोकना आसान है, पर जर्म्स को रोकना, इसीलिए डाबर च्यवनप्राश। इसमें है आमला, अश्वगंधा जैसे 41 आयुर्वेदिक हर्ब्स जो बारिश में भी बनाए इम्यूनिटी स्ट्रांग। डाबर च्यवनप्राश, डबल इम्यूनिटी।
I hope you guys enjoyed this video. So coming to DABUR CHYAWAN PRASH, the best Ayurvedic in today's market. So DABUR CHYAWAN PRASH is not just one of the largest brand in leading brand in DABUR healthcare range, but it is the leader in the branded CHYAWAN PRASH range. It has clinically proven benefits for maintaining a good healthy life, and it helps in stimulating and maintaining, strengthening the immune system and protecting from everyday's infection and bacteria. And it has been more than 50 years in the competition, and the credit it goes to DABUR because it has invested heavily in its product development and consumer awareness.
So coming to the timeline of DABUR CHYAWAN PRASH, they have launched their first product in 1949 in a tin packaging. After that, in 95, they have done some improvisation in their product by increasing more honey and less pungency. And Dabur is known for raising bars for other brands. So in 2010, they have launched a flavored Chyawan Prash, that is orange and mango. And currently, they have introduced sugar-free Chyawan Prash. As in today's era, we all are very conscious for our health. So they consider that also. Coming to competitors, these are the three big rivals of Dabur, and one of the biggest rival is Patanjali, in the market Dabur Chyawan Prash shares 70% of the market.
So coming to the four P's, first is the price category. As you can see, the Chyawan Prash, it ranges from 135 to 190, which differs according to different brands. But we observe that Dabur Chyawan Prash is a bit, it costs a bit high. But people are more focused towards the quality which Dabur maintains.
So here we can see in products that Dabur Chyawan Prash has categorized its product in different varieties according to the age group and features. So we can see the 2x immunity, that is double immunity. It is for boosting immunity and it is for adults. Mixed fruit, mango and chocolate flavor is for kids and it helps them fighting from illness. Sugar free is safe for diabetic patients. And Ratna Prash is for all the adults for increasing their stamina and stigma.
Place. Dabur has many manufacturing units that has been scattered across in India. The unit 2, which is located in Baddi, it deals in Himachal Pradesh. It deals with manufacturing of Chyawan Prash. Dabur basically it uses its sales force and distribution channels to market its product.
Coming to promotions, it is very important for any company to do promotions very very effectively. Dabur has a special feature that they keep on changing their brand ambassador. So now can you anyone tell me who is the brand ambassador of Dabur Chyawan Prash? Sorry, it is Madhi Dixit. So here are, and they have also hired Ravi Kishan to do promotional activities in the region UP, and they also do campaigns in which they give free health checkups. Also, they right now on Amazon, when we purchase a chocolate brand of chocolate flavor of Chyawan Prash, they are giving a free sipper. So these all are their strategies to increase their market and attract their consumers.
Coming to SWOT analysis, first is strength. As we know, Dabur has like many people trust Dabur. So first strong point is its brand trust. Second, coming to the flexibility with the dealers, Dabur offers its dealers with 30 days of flexibility. That is, it allows them to stock the product and then they can pay after 30 days. Coming to the weakness, Dabur does not focus on promoting its product through brand retail stores. So it sells its product along with other brands in medical stores and general stores. Coming to opportunities, Dabur can promote its product through Ayurvedic health clubs and brand retail stores. And nowadays, as people are more towards are health conscious and are relying on herbal products, so they have a wider scope. Coming to the threats, it has rising competition and various introduction of substitutes can hamper their market sales.
Veda was, as I have already told that Patanjali is one of the biggest rival of Dabur. So when it came to the market in 2015, there was a big disturbance in the FMCG market and as well as in the shares of Dabur. As we can see here, it fall down to 57%.
So aggressive, so Dabur, after the downfall, it came up with aggressive strategies. That is, it organized 620 health camps where Ayurvedic practitioners treated 1 lakh patients, then 250